Hey guys, it's Kelly. I'm going to do a tutorial. I'm going to show you how to make fall leaves out of paper and alcohol inks. So I'll tell you what everything you're going to need. So get ready. Make a list. And then you can pause me and then you can do it with me if you'd like. So I did a tutorial back in September, 2 years ago, of one of my favorite techniques. I am in love with alcohol inks. I always have been. It's one of my favorite things to use in my craft room. So, and I love this time of year because of the change of the leaves. Now I live in Arizona, so I'm missing that, so I'm definitely going to do them. So what you'll need, first thing you need is your nonstick craft sheet. I like to have a couple of these on hand because I use alcohol inks a lot. I have one that's dedicated just to alcohol inks because it does get kind of, it cleans up very well, but once you get little scrapes in it, it kind of oozes in there and you'll see. So I like to have one that's just dedicated to my alcohol inking. So nonstick craft sheet. You're going to need some alcohol inks. The ones that I like best for doing fall leaves are the following colors. All of mine are the Adirondack alcohol inks. I like to use cranberry, currant, caramel, ginger, and butterscotch. Those are my favorite color combinations for making that fall color. There's plenty of other colors, but that's just the combination that I like. Then you will also need some alcohol blending solution. You will need clear embossing ink. Now if you have VersaMark and you do not have this, that's fine. You just have to make sure that you saturate it. So the clear embossing ink by Stampendous I like because it's got this little spongy thing and I can really saturate it on there. And I like that. Okay, you'll need some tweezers, your heat gun tool, then you will need clear embossing powder. Now there's a difference here. You've got Yuti and clear embossing powder. For those that don't know, here's the difference. Ultra thick embossing enamel is what Yuti stands for. Okay, it's very thick, very glass-like once you heat it up. Okay, clear embossing powder is more just a raised embossing powder, and it's very fine. I like this one best for this. I think that the Yuti is going to crack a little bit too much. I haven't tried it with Yuti. Plus, when you heat it up with your heat tool, it blows everywhere. So this is a lot neater for me. So I stick with the clear embossing powder instead of the Yuti. And that is the difference, the coarseness of it. Okay? This is an enamel, this is an embossing powder. And this is mainly used for melting pot, but you can use it for other things. Okay? And then a container to put it in. And very, very important, for cleanup you need 91% rubbing alcohol. Okay? If you get anything less than that, it's not going to clean up like you need it to. So 91%, that is the key to cleanup, easy cleanup. Okay? You can have some gloves if you want, it's not necessary, but it does get very messy. So I have a glove on one hand. And then you'll need a die cut for your leaf. Now these are very whimsically. It's the only one I have right now. Okay, Tim Holtz has a beautiful, beautiful die cut for leaves. And I love that one. I just don't have that one. So I'm just going to show you with what I've got. The one that I used for 2 years ago, I don't have that one anymore either. So we're just going to go with what we got. No big deal. Okay, I think that's everything. So go grab all your stuff and pause me and come back to me. Okay? Okay, so the first thing that we are going to do is, I'm going to do two and play with the colors I know that works, and then I'll try with some colors that I'm not sure if they work or not. Okay? So first thing you're going to do is get your embossing powder ready. Take your lid off. And take your leaves and put your clear embossing ink all over it. And again, like I said, saturate it. You want it to go all the way through that paper. And by the way, the paper, sorry, I don't think I mentioned this, the paper that you need is really, really heavy cardstock, or like I'm using, just manila file folder. I just put that right through my Cricut machine and die cut it that way. So, and I am against rubbing it across because then it makes a smooth surface. and I have yet to see a leaf during fall time, during the autumn. I can't believe I just said that, fall time. I've yet to see a leaf that is very smooth. It's always kind of, it's kind of like sticky, okay? And shiny in some areas. And that's what I love about this technique, is because it comes out shiny, and you'll see. Okay? Oh, you also need paper towels or baby wipes. I like baby wipes for cleaning up the embossing powder, and then the paper towels I like to use for cleaning up at the end when you use your rubbing alcohol, your 91% rubbing alcohol. I like doing it that way. Okay. So, make sure, I like it on there nice and thick because you want it to kind of bubble up. Okay, so there they are. Grab your heat gun and heat it up. There they go. Be careful with them because they do get hot. Obviously, you just use your heat gun, so it gets pretty hot. So now they're nice and embossed. And let me see if I can bring you guys in a little bit closer. My camera's at a really funky angle, so bear with me here. Okay, I need to not move them from where they are. Give them a second to cool off. Now there's a couple areas where I can emboss a little bit more, so I'm gonna do that. There we go. And even if I didn't reheat that, it would have been just fine. Okay. So now, here's the fun part. So we just start adding color on there. Now I like that really deep, rich, reddish brown color. So I like to kind of put the cranberry and currant on there. I love that red color that they get. I'm put that right in the middle. So that was currant. This, maybe I'll leave the lids off for a little bit. This is cranberry. Put it right on top of the currant. And there's no like science to this, guys. You have to play and find what you like. If it doesn't work out, you literally used very little bit of product to figure it out. This is ginger, a little bit more ginger, and a lot of people on my tutorial that I did a while ago, now I'm using caramel, were like, you're wasting so much, oh my gosh, why are you wasting, you don't have to put that much. Now here's the thing, these bottles are still very full, and I've had these for almost 3 years, and I use them a lot. So, you know what? I'm not wasting. I'm using. I don't think I'm wasting at all. So, and I'm not going to stress about what I waste. I'm going to play with my stuff. Okay. So now I got my colors on there. They're kind of oozing around. Then you put your blending solution on there. And they're going to start mixing. And then you take your leaf and you turn it over. And you swirl it around in the magic. And just play with it. It's alcoholing, so it starts evaporating. I like to soak it in there for a little bit. And turn it over and see what you got. Ooh, see, I like that. I love that golden color. I think it's beautiful. I think I want a little bit more current though. I'm gonna put it right on there. I love the richness of that. See, I really like that. I hope you guys do too. I love how rich that color is right there. I like it so much I might have to do it again. I'm not getting that same effect. You see how that... Ah! I hope I'm getting in the screen here. I get excited and then I get out of... There we go. See? I love that variation. If you want to just dip the tips, because if you notice leaves, when you pick them up, you know, the tips are a little bit different shade than the rest of them. So they shouldn't be, there's nothing perfect about it. It should be completely not perfect. There we go. I love how those turned out. Love it, love it, love it. Okay. I'm going to leave that because I can reactivate that with my blending solution and make more leaves. Okay? I've got one more die cut here. Well, two more that I can do. And I'll show you how to do that. So, but let me bring you back out, or back in. Okay, I want you guys to see what happens when I heat these up. Because now you're going to reactivate the alcohol ink, and it's going to ooze into the embossing powder and change things up a little bit. Bubbled up. See the bubbles that happen? I think that's cool. I love the bubbles. Because look, it gives you variations. You can pop them if you want, and then it looks even cooler. I think that is awesome. And hopefully you guys do too. You can see how it has like that stickiness to it. So now these, you got to be careful. If you touch them, they're sticky, so you got to give them time to dry. So I'm going to put these off to the side. And I'll revisit those in just a second. I love how those turned out. Okay, so now I have all this ink here that I can reuse if I want. And we'll experiment a little bit. Because I don't know if these other colors that I kind of want to introduce are going to work or not. Like the terracotta and the bottle. The bottle, I'm not sure about. But we'll see. So let me bring you back out. And we'll play a little bit more. So we'll start again. Let me get my powder ready. And you saturate it. Be careful, don't push this, like squeeze this bottle. If you squeeze the bottle, I had a friend over here and we were creating together and she was using her embossing powder, or embossing ink. And she squeezed it, and the top came off, and it spilled all over. It was terrible. It was a mess. And she wasted it, because then you can't really save it. And your manila file folder, if that's what you use, is going to soak it up pretty good. So once you get it on there, try to get it in your powder pretty quick. And shake it up. And then the embossing powder is sticky. So just clean that off so you don't reintroduce that stuff again. Okay. And grab your leaf. Ah. Where's the other one? Disappeared. There it is. Okay. Now we're going to heat it up. hot. And then the under part starts sticking because you still got embossing powder underneath too. So give it a minute to cool. Just a minute. A little bit warm, but that's okay. All right, so I've got all this cool color right here, and I'm gonna put some blending solution down, just a little bit, and I'm gonna stick it in there. I'm gonna get this really pretty golden color, which is nice, but not really what I like the best. Smear it all around, take advantage of what I've already got down. And then we're gonna play, I think I'm gonna add some terracotta. And I think, I don't know how it's gonna work. And this time, instead of putting it directly on here, I'm gonna put it down. So there's terracotta, here's some latte. And we'll try some bottle. This is the one I'm not sure about. I think it's gonna be too bluish green. Well, we'll see. Maybe it'll be just the right combination. That actually looked pretty cool. I kind of like that. I'll put more in there. And put more blending solution. It's just a matter of playing with your stuff. I mean, I don't know if it's right. I don't know. I'm gonna put some ginger too. Try this one again. Kind of like that. The bottle is more of a patina kind of color. But when you mix it with the brown, I think it gives it that really nice, rich brown hue. But now I've got too much brown going, so I'm thinking maybe some cranberry will even that out. Give it some red. See, I love that. Just a hint of red. Just dab it in there and then get it right out. Nice. So the terracotta wasn't really, I'm not really impressed with the terracotta, but I do like the cranberry. And I'm using a little less blending solution because I want the vibrancy of the color of the red on there. Ah, I lost some of it. Yeah, I like those. Those look nice. Okay. So now we got more magic that can happen here. And I'll try and bring it in again so you can see what happens. Okay, sorry if I'm making you dizzy. My camera is not in the best angle here. So bear with me just a minute. There you go. I think you can see it from there. And here's what we heated up again. There we go. And I think that looks really cool. And I love how this one has the total different shades on all the edges. It's totally different. Every way you look at it. And you can see, let me bring it back out again. That none of them are the same. You never get the exact same result. And make sure you let them dry because these are still kind of warm, so they're sticking to me. You got to get them to dry. I like it. I think it looks great. So there you go. Which one did I just do? Oh, they're all cooled off now. That's one that I just did. So, and you can do the backside if you want too. But, and then if you want, you can bend them and get a cool little crack down there. And you can get the embossing powder to crack for you. And I think that that's a really cool thing, but be careful because it'll crack and then peel right off if you do it too much. So there they are. Look, a whole bunch of fall leaves right there. I love it. So I hope you guys give it a try. And if you do, make sure you let me know. I would love to see the different color variations that you guys came up with, the different colors that you have. And if you found a new way to make them, I would love to see that too, because this is one of my favorite things to make, is fall leaves. It's my favorite time of year. So thanks for watching, guys, and hopefully I can bring you in a little closer and you can see the details. I'm sorry, guys, it's really hard for me to see whether or not it's focusing. You see the shininess, and it has like a stickiness to it. It's very cool. It's a cool technique, very real looking. And I hope you guys like it. Give it a try. Don't forget to like, comment, and I'll be back soon with another page in my 28-page mini-series that I'm doing for my art journal. Thanks, guys. Wait a minute. I forgot to show you guys how to clean up. Hold on. Let me show you where the alcohol ink comes in. See? I was so excited. There you go. This is where your alcohol ink comes in. You grab your paper towel. You're gonna love this if you guys don't already know how easy this is. You could still leave this down here and make more leaves, but I think I'm done for now. I'm not worried about wasting it. I still have tons left. Look at that. Look how easy that is. All gone. All clean. Perfect. All right, guys. Again, thanks for watching. Don't forget to comment, share, and let me know if you guys tried it. I'd love to see what you came up with. Thanks, guys. Bye.